this series, I really want to show my genuine like reaction and struggles and everything that I learned when upgrading my mining rig. I've mined for a long time now, but never seriously, usually like on a CPU or something, or maybe on my gaming PC, or maybe a couple more. But as I kind of got older and I really believed in crypto, and I was like, you know what, I want to invest more into it, I want to build a mining rig. I got lucky when I built it. I really got bigger in 2020. But this is going to be my genuine reaction, and it's going to be clipped a little bit weird. One thing you're going to notice, though, is how it's going to be edited. And the main thing is I made this with Snapchat. I was sending it to friends and family, giving them updates on kind of my whole adventure in life. So that's why it's going to be a little weird. It's not going to be as if I was trying to portray it that way, but I also wanted to do that instead of just giving in my opinion, a boring, okay, this is what I did, this is what I went through, which maybe I'll do later. But I'd rather just show you my genuine reaction and what I had to go through. I mean, the first thing that happened to me is my power supplies caught fire, and I had to learn a lot about the electricity, and there's a lot to it when you get bigger, when you actually take it to the next level. Now, I don't have some massive mining farm, but I did have a good amount of graphic cards, and I do think this is something anyone can do. And I encourage other people to do as well. So, here's the series. I'll probably make a couple clips here or there, kind of maybe explain some situations. And, yeah, that's about it. And I'd also love to share any information, like, what did I overclock? And, you know, what did I undervolt? Things like that. I have a lot of information about that. But I'll get into all of that. I'm in my garage right now, so just to tell you as well, whenever I'm recording, there's going to be some audio that's going to be kind of hard to hear, which is why I might have to edit some things. But the reason it's so hard is I have a lot of fans running. So, that's what's going to be really taking up a lot of that background sound, is those fans. And it's not going to be just from the graphic cards and everything, too. It's going to be from the ventilation I installed in the garage. There was a whole process of me learning how to handle this. So excuse the background sound, and again, please enjoy. By the way, we have all the graphic cards, finally, we have all of them. Now, why are we missing a couple? What's going on? And why do I have some power supplies over here that aren't working? Well, I got a little bit of a story for you guys. So last night, after we got all the cards, I was real excited. I got all the graphic cards, BIOS modded, everything. And it took me forever to get all into compute mode, and finally around 10 o'clock at night, I finally get it all done. I'm so excited. And I hook it up, start the program, and next thing you know, it turns off and I see smoke. I'm like, oh god, what's going on? I bought these cheap, unbranded, unnamed Chinese power supplies for $100 each. 1,800 watts. I was like, man, I know this is a scam. There ain't no way it's gonna work. But if it's real, it's too good to pass up. And I'm willing to risk $100 to test this. And I tested it, and it's working. It worked up to like 1,700 watts or something. I was like really impressed, and it was reliable. And I'm like, this is awesome. I gotta use this. And I looked at the person who sold it to me. Still has one more left to sell. And I'm like, I'm buying that one. So I spent $200, got the second one, and I tested it, turned it on, works like a charm. So the reason it caught fire is I accidentally overdid the power that I was putting through the wattage. But what it's supposed to happen is it's supposed to shut off, not catch on fire. So it caught fire. I'm very frustrated, whatever. I still have another one that I bought that I already tested. I know that it works. And I'm not going to overdo it this time, and I just can't use all the graphic cards till I get the better power supply. I hook in my second unbranded Chinese 1,800 watt power supply, the one that I've already tested, and I can't get it to turn on. It's just dead. So apparently that one only worked the day that I tested it. And now it's a very funny story. It was not funny for me last night. And here I am now, testing You see, I've been taking all of them off the rack one at a time, testing every single graphic card to make sure nothing broke. So far, so good. So, the moral of this story: don't buy cheap Chinese power supplies and put it on your $4,000 mining rig. Don't do it. It's not a good idea. Now I gotta wait a week for my new power supplies to come in, which I paid the proper amount. Now it's 1600 watts, not 1800, and I paid 400 each. All right, update number two for the servers. I know these blue ones, they're called risers, they're stable, but these green ones, I bought them like years ago before I even knew I was going to be doing GPU mining, so I don't know if they're stable. And I also did a software change, so I gotta find out, is it those risers or is it the software change? But it kept crashing every hour or two, sometimes it crashed in 20 minutes. It's finally cool in here. 74 right now. It was nearly 90 degrees earlier, but I fixed that. I have open window. It's, you know, only the 30s today, so, but it's gonna be bad in the summer, so I'm gonna get an AC unit for in here. It's gonna be real bad, but yeah, just to finish it off, so I have 10 graphic cards up right now. It's actually taking two massive 1600 watt power supplies. Those are my couple dead Chinese ones that I bought. But I have 10 running there. I have two running in this server. I'm gonna move it over there at a different date to test. And then I have three more running upstairs. But it's a good space heater. Good electricity burner, and hopefully I don't go broke on the mining rigs. You can see I have 10 right there, two in here. I'm about to put up even more on this mining rig soon, and I got three more upstairs, and it's been running for a day and a half actually, now I think about it, and got my first payment from it of about $63. I've been earning money from it before. This is the first time as it's been fully together. So right now it's looking like I'm gonna make about 60 plus bucks every 2 days. So there's a couple things I'm trying to fix. The reason I'm actually missing two on this slot is the two that are supposed to be in there are actually in here. I'm having issues getting them to work on here. So I've been swapping out the graphic cards one at a time to find out which one is the problem. So that's why we're not fully operational yet. So it's finally cooling down a little bit. You can see it's 76.4 right now. When I walked in here this morning, none of the windows were open, and it was almost 100 degrees in here. I think it was like the high 90s. I know it was above 96 degrees. So it was really, really hot. So during the winter, window one, window two, window three. That is our cooling system. And I'll be honest, it's actually quite comfortable in here. Once we get more graphic cards, I'm sure it's gonna be even hotter. I'm now looking into an AC unit and getting this into the garage. I'm having humidity issues in the garage. I've been testing it for about a couple weeks now, trying different things, trying to get that humidity down. Then we get the humidity down to a good server level, this will be going to the garage. But I'm gonna be a Bitcoin millionaire, guys. I decided to give you guys another update on the mining rigs. So far, since it's all been put up, right now I'm being paid around roughly $55 every, I'd say, day or day and a half. But let me show you. So the big mining rig, you can see it's missing now three graphic cards. I had to take another one out. I've been having a lot of issues with these. I think I found out which one was the problem. I think it was actually this one. I'm getting random crashes, and when I get it to be stable, it only lasts like 28 hours. So I got my second mining rig up. You can see it only has one graphic card right now, but that's getting up and going. You can see it's mining right here, hash rate of 26. This bad boy is mining some Darrow. It could be a useless coin or it could turn out to be something one day. To keep it cool, so usually I have that window open. But I ended up opening this window and I have the fan moving. So that's pushing all the hot air out and that's actually working tremendously. Then I had the second window open and it was working too well. It was too cold in here and it was making the house cold. So I closed this and now it's getting too hot again. See, it's already 77 in here. So we're trying to get that cooling to a good temperature during winter. You're on Snapchat, baby.
Why am I on Snapchat?
Hey, Vina.
Oh my God.
And then this is how I'm currently analyzing everything. You can see I'm remoted in, watching this one. This computer also has another one open right here. And I watch the Linux system through this. So you see I can watch the third one. So I watch a lot of my active workers and how it's doing. There's all my machines that are mining. So I'm getting a pretty good hash rate right now. That's the bad graphic card. So I've got to fix that or send it back. I'm missing money on that. Also watch it through here. This is where I watch my Darrow. I don't get very much Darrow. I don't put much in that one. But the last thing I'm gonna do on this server specifically, because this is on a UPS backup, I'm gonna start staking them. And you can see right here, Zaliqua is 16% return per year. Cardano is 5%. So I'll be staking. And all the Ethereum that I'm mining with all the coins, I'm also gonna be mining. Because this year you're allowed to mine and stake at the same time. So I'm gonna double dip in that while you can before they get rid of mining. I mean, it's pretty fun. Just hope I don't lose all my money with it. But I guess I haven't invested that much. But it is pretty fun.